25-year-old only-eyed patient with no previous records presented with gradually decreasing vision over 3 years in his right eye. He gave a history of having lost his left eye completely 28 years ago after a road traffic accident in a remote Indian village. He had suffered a penetrating injury in his right eye, a corneal laceration, which according to the history had been primarily repaired and subsequently suffered from an infection and emergency full thickness corneal grafting had been undertaken. He did give a history of fairly normal vision post PK in his remaining right eye. He had travelled more than 500 kilometres from a remote Indian village to the city of Joy to seek a chance at second sight, which for him was going to be exclusive and expensive medical treatment. On examination, his vision in his only seeing eye was counting fingers at 2.5 meters, improving to 636 with pinhole. There was an advanced cataract with a surprisingly clear graft, considering the operation was done more than 28 years ago with no previous records. The intraocular pressure was normal and fundoscopy revealed no abnormality. The biometry, which was repeated at 2 separate centres by 2 separate highly skilled technicians with an OcuScan and a Topcon machine respectively, revealed a highly myopic right eye with an increased axial length and high astigmatism of approximately 4 diopters with the rule. Without facilities for corneal topography or IOL master at our centre, it was decided to implant this only-eyed, highly myopic patient without the financial means with a plus 13 diopter hydrophobic acrylic IOL. A horizontal superiotemporal corneoscleral approach was taken, incision being made on the steeper axis. Phaco was done by a stop-chop technique using phaco in situ. Coaxial cortical aspiration was completed in this only-eyed myopic patient without any complications. The capsular bag was injected with OVD and then the preloaded acrylic IOL with multi-piece haptics with hybrid technology was injected into the bag. It decided to eject out in a reverse fashion, which was later positioned carefully. The operation had been conducted with no previous past records, bare minimum pre-op investigations, cautious surgical technique with a new generation preloaded economical acrylic IOL. Post-operatively, that patient was seen on day 1 and day 7 respectively. His cornea was clear and his vision was amazingly 6-9 part with a minus 1 cylinder at 90 degrees. The choice of a plus 13 diopter IOL proved to be the right choice. God willing, he had a very satisfactory end result. After travelling almost bare feet, many miles from a remote Indian village to the city of Joy, this only-eyed patient achieved a miraculous second sight.